go from this to this. Stay with us and we'll show you how to do that now. Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. In today's video guys, we're going to show you how to make your dirty engine like a brand new looking engine again. Stay with us guys, just for a few dollars guys, we'll show you how to clean your engine and make it look like brand new again. We guys have more than 200 videos on every car we get at the shop. Please subscribe guys. If you need any specific videos, drop a comment below and we'll try to help you solve your problem. So, what do we have here? 2013 Hyundai Sonata guys that we won at car auction. Copart, so you can check out the video guys, we paid very cheap price for that car. But now we need to clean our engine. Okay, you can see it looks terrible, never been cleaned probably, or at least for the last, I don't know, 2-3 years. It looks terrible, so we'll show you guys what method we use and it will cost you less than a dollar in my opinion to clean it. So usually if you have an engine cover guys, okay, you want to remove it if you want to degrease it good, because under the engine cover, okay, this is your engine cover, you're going to have guys, okay, right here your valve cover and the valve cover gasket, and usually you will have some oil accumulation there. Now let me explain quick. This is your valve cover, those are ignition coils, this is high pressure fuel pump, newer vehicles will have that. Also here on some cars you will have the engine computer. In the engine bay, this is a fuse box, this is your air filter box, car battery, and on this side you have alternator, AC compressor and all that stuff. So what do we guys do now? Okay, we need to get some aluminum foil, okay, just aluminum foil for cooking. We're going to get a small amount and we'll show you guys, okay, what we do with it. It's that way we're not going to get our connectors, okay, connectors wet, and we will have lower chance of getting something wet and not performing right. There is always a chance to get your ignition coils wet and spark plugs wet when you clean your engine, so if you do that you will need to remove the ignition coils, okay, and just dry them. That's the only thing. But with aluminum foil guys, okay, we're going to wrap the ignition coils, okay, the wiring harness, so that way water cannot get in the wires. Later we can remove that. Why we use the foil? Because it's super easy to wrap around it. You can use either plastic foil as well. And we're going to do that to the ignition coils. Okay, and later we're going to do that to the computer. Okay, to the computer wiring there as well. So we'll go ahead, do that. Okay, and we'll be ready guys to continue with the next step. So we'll get a big piece, we're going to cover the connectors for the computer and we're going to wipe those later, okay, by hand. You don't want to get it wet there, so cover those really good, okay, just like that. Now if you have a MAF sensor, other connectors that are exposed, do that as well. We have the diagnostic port right here, so I'm going to cover this one as well, okay, that way it's not going to get wet too on top. And we have one right there for the high pressure fuel pump. We have one wire as well. If you have some such as MAF sensor, you can do those. Okay, this is another connector there that we'll do. And some vehicles like this one, you can even do the VVT solenoids, but usually those don't get wet. But you can do them as well. And if the throttle body is too obvious, you can do it as well. But in our case, it's not too obvious. That's your throttle body. So what we'll be using now, guys? This is one of the cheapest degreasers. People will spend crazy money on engine degreasing and all that stuff. In my opinion, that thing works amazing. Nothing sponsored here. It's something we use here quite a bit at the shop. It's a Purple Power. You can dilute that thing or you can use it straight out of the container. What we usually do, okay, we put some in a spray bottle so we can spray it, or you can buy it in a small spray bottle. We will have the links for all the tools guys, okay, and all the cleaners that we use listed in the description of the video below. Every video that we do guys, all the tools and replacement parts will be listed below for your convenience. So we're going to fill it up, okay, just to show you here that that's the material that we're using, that's the product and nothing else. Okay, and Now, we'll go ahead, place the tube in. Okay, and we're going to get our nozzle. Okay, it goes the other way like that. Just get it tight, and now, do not even get the engine wet. Now, let me explain something quick. You want to do that on a very cold engine. Let it stay overnight and do it next morning, because that way, if you have something hot, you're not going to crack it. You're not going to damage it. So, we're going to do our hood now on top here, because you can see this is terrible here. If you get your piece wet there too much, it's going to sag later. You'll be sagging, so don't get it too wet, the soft piece. You want to cover the whole plastic really good. Everywhere you have plastic, if you leave spots, okay, let's come back a little bit. Okay, perfect. It's not going to clean. Great. And now we'll just soak everything like that. And you guys are going to see the results in just a little bit. First, being a cold engine, okay, it's not going to dry fast. It will have some time to work and degrease everything. So we'll keep doing that and we'll continue. Stay until the end to see how we're going to dry it, so you will not have misfires or engine not starting. We'll explain what needs to be done. Here, guys, the intake, I'm going to cover it, okay, so we don't get it wet and we don't get water inside of it. You want to cover your intake where the car is sucking air from, that way, okay, you will not cause any damage. We'll need to spray just a little bit more on top of our box here, probably. Yep, you can see it's eating it now. And we can hit those spots a few more times here. Okay, the oil deposits. Now, this is your valve cover. The foamy piece on the back side. You can remove it and dry it. If you get it wet, dry it, guys, and then put it on the car, because otherwise, okay, it can get connectors wet later. So we're going to do that to the whole cover, and we'll show you what to do next. Now we'll be using a very low pressure power washer right here, guys. You can find this one listed in the description of the video below. Very cheap, guys. And we'll show you guys, okay, what we're going to do now. Let me connect it quick. Okay, so we'll be ready to continue. Do not spray too close. Okay, you want to keep some distance. The plastic is fine, but the cables, always stay away from them. We're going to start with the hood now. Okay, that piece, we can clean the dust, but do not get it too wet. Right here on the back, do not spray the carpet, because you will break it. You want to spray it from distance only. So we're underneath now. We're going to heat it up there as well. Check out all the nastiness coming out. Okay, to do the engine cover one more time. And later guys, we'll show you how to use the vacuum here, okay, so we can dry. Okay. Perfect. So, what do we guys need to do now? We need to go ahead and remove all the cable, all the aluminum foil from the other cables. And right here, you can see we didn't wash so clean, so much around the ignition coils because we always get water in. And what we'll be doing, okay, we'll remove all that stuff and we'll use the vacuum to remove all the water around the ignition coils. Now, if you get some water in the ignition coils, guys, the correct thing to do, okay, is you will need to remove the ignition coil, usually with one bolt, pull it out, dry the spark plugs and the coils, and you will be, guys, pretty much ready to go. So, okay, let me remove those now. Okay, we're almost ready now. Okay, and now with the shop vac. You can wipe the connectors, okay, just gently wipe them without getting them too wet, guys. Okay, and later, okay, we can get the engine cover, put it on if the foam piece is dry, and you can see, guys, how clean that engine is compared to when we started. Remember how bad it was? Okay, it was terrible, guys. Perfect. Just like that. So hopefully guys, the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and see you guys next time.